Hello, Foodizens. Welcome to ISL Lounge once again, brought to you by FCast. So, what a match! This is what we all get to see in a derby. And at the end of the day, we see the green and maroon brigades, an ecstatic green and maroon brigades, just celebrating like before. So, and we have a very sad red and gold frontier. So once again, with me on the panel, I have got Orko and Somodi with me. So I'll straight away go to you guys because this is a derby. I think both of you have a lot to say, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. So hi, Footizens. This was an enthralling derby, to say the least. The match started off in a very cagey affair, as we had spoken before. Habas was very KG in his setup of defense, and unlike what we expected from a striker coach in Robbie Fowler, East Bengal did start off cautiously, but they were quick to find their groove, setting up a very good chance for Balwant Singh, who couldn't finish it, a very great cross from the right wing. And Pilkington did have his chance of getting away shots. But credit to the Mohunbagan defense. They always showed him less opportunity to, you know, strike the ball. He has got a very sweet left foot. And he was forced to shoot on his right foot in the second half too. You know, so, yeah, Somodi, I guess you had something to say about Pilkington's role in the match.
He did show some signs of promise in bits and pieces. He's going to be an excellent player as the season progresses. I'm yet to see that because this team just spent 2.5 weeks together. So I think they have a lot more time to spend and a few more games to go before they really show us what they have. So right. Robbie's team did start well against ATK Mohunbagan, but Habas is Habas. He did something that he usually does. He sat back, soaked in pressure, and when the time was right, he went on the counter and he got two goals. One from Roy Krishna.
Yeah, exactly. That was absolutely beautiful.
I just want to ask you guys, this guy, Roy Krishna, is an absolute poacher. And he is just continuing from where he had left in the last season, and which is bringing joy in a lot of people's heart who are supporting ATK Mohunbagan. Isn't it? So, yeah, this year, we are just seeing that same old Roy Krishna.
Yeah, he's a very good player to watch. I mean, even for the neutrals, he has goals in him. Wherever he has gone, this Fijian has scored a lot of goals. And most of the seasons that he has played in A-League, he has got 20-plus goals, which for a striker is a decent job. And Roy Krishna, to have Devjit, I mean, to have Devjit fooled the way that he did. I mean, Devjit is an excellent shot stopper. And still, he on the left foot, his weaker foot, Roy Krishna did manage to beat him. That was a chance well taken.
So, he has scored both the goals now with the left foot. This is it.
Absolutely. But there are two more players I would like to shed some light on. One of them is Carl McHugh, and one of them is the other one is Javi Garcia. Two midfield engines that did a lot of work to stop East Bengal from causing damage in the lower half, in the attacking third.
Exactly. McHugh probably marked the main man, Pilkington, out of the game. I mean, he sat so well in front of the defense, three-man defense, throughout the match, that Pilkington is a striker who likes to drop in deep, get the ball and then have a shot at goal. And he completely nullified Pilkington throughout the game, always trying to show him onto his weaker right foot, which was excellent work.
And absolutely. Also, you have to specially mention the solo goal by Manvir Singh. I think this is one of the best solo goals I have seen in my my history. Whenever I have watched Derby, I think this was the best solo goal I have seen.
Probably. Definitely.
I think this is the best solo goal he'd ever scored in a match.
True that.
Leave out a derby. Because, I mean, when he came along to ATK Mohunbagan, there was a lot of question because the price was really high on him. The tag was really high. And I didn't think I don't think he had a very huge scoring season last year, but he did bring some promise because he's young. He's good on the ball.
He has got a beautiful left foot. I mean, yeah. Any left-footed player, we love to watch left-footed players. And he has that kind of Di Maria Robin thing going on behind him, cutting in inside the box and then firing a shot in the far left corner.
I mean, also, I'd say Scott Neville was pretty bemused at the end of the goal because he had brought in a lot of headlines before the game that he's someone that Mohan Bagan should be aware of. Yeah, and I think Scott Neville would not be amused with that goal. I don't think so.
And also, I think you guys have to will agree with me because in a match like this, you cannot give away chances like Balwant did. I think that was an easy score, in my opinion.
Yeah. At that time, the match was a 0-0 draw when Balwant missed a chance, and it could have been 1-0 for East Bengal, and suddenly the game would have changed. But after scoring the goal, the perfect timing of Manveer's substitution. He came on for Williams. Williams had a decent game for a forward, chasing balls up front, pressing the defenders. But Abbas bringing on Manveer changed the dynamics of Mohan Bagan to a certain extent. Having a left-footed right winger is always an asset to your team. And they can stretch the defense, they can cut inside. So that's what made a difference to the game also. Abbas getting the second goal through Manveer.
And I think this
that
is
was becoming, a tactical masterstroke.
This is becoming a practice in modern-day football with having the right-wing forward, having a left-footed right-wing forward. Because I think there are so many teams and so many quality players over the years. Even since Robin had started, we have seen so many quality players doing that. And it's lovely that even Indian football is following that trend. So this is something I'm really loving about it, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
And also, yes, please.
There's a sweet history that I read in the papers yesterday that Manveer's father was a footballer too. His name was Kuldeep Singh. So he worked for the Punjab Electricity Board. And he was offered by both Mohan Bagan and East Bengal in his prime days to come and play in Kolkata. He couldn't, but his son did. And after the game, it was a very emotional moment for him. And his father said that on call, the first statement that he made was, "I did it, father."
Oh, so that's a really lovely and emotional story to have. And also, somewhere on a very lighter note, I just want to say, I just saw a meme where it was about Balwant, where it was written that it was an excellent piece of defending from Balwant. So I think that is really hilarious. So having said that, I would like to go for the stat attack. I would just try to bring in some things to your attention. I think the stats are entirely in East Bengal's favor. What I can see is, if you see the total number of shots, East Bengal had 15 as compared to Mohan Bagan had 12. But shots on target, yeah, I think
quality.
Yes.
Quality.
And shots on target, Mohan Bagan were 3 and East Bengal were 2. So that is the number where Mohan Bagan made the difference. Whereas East Bengal had a possession of 68% as compared to Mohan Bagan's 32%. And total number of passes completed by East Bengal was 521, which is a very good number as compared to Mohan Bagan's 241. Even they had they were superior in passing accuracy, 81% to 65%. And corners were evenly poised with 5 corners each. And fouls were also, because tactical fouls are so much a part of the game nowadays, so we can't really draw conclusions from that fouls thing. But
there were 5 yellow cards in the game also.
Yeah.
Which points out to the fact that East Bengal are yet to get off their blocks. I mean, they are stringing their passes well. They have played a number of passes, and which we are on an average, we were seeing the number of passes in each game decreasing, like 200, 250 plus passes. And now East Bengal in their first match that they're playing in this tournament. And also
they were a bit unlucky. They were a bit unlucky, I feel, because they are playing the first match and they are playing the derby, because we all know in a derby,
exactly,
you have this added pressure because everybody.
Yeah. First match being a derby is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I heard from previous players that everybody calls them and speaks to them, and only thing they say is, please win the derby. So there is an added pressure not only from the fans but also from their family members, because everybody wants to win the derby. And they are, for the very first match, in a very special match, they are playing the ISL after so much. They fought for it. They fought for their slot. And the very first match, they had to play the derby. Isn't it?
Yeah, but things would have been excellent to see if the derby was being played at Salt Lake Stadium. I mean, Yuva Bharati Kriangan. But the pressure was a bit less on that part. Yeah, that would have been a dynamo, right?
Yeah. So
definitely been a dynamo, and all right.
So having said that, we will end the derby podcast right here. But today, because this is a derby, we have a fanboy who will be joining us shortly. So we will meet at the fan section. Thank you so much.
Welcome to the fan zone of the ISL Lounge, brought to you by FCast. And today we have an ecstatic Mohunbagan fan in Bhaskar Ganguly. Dr. Bhaskar Ganguly, he also happens to be closely associated with FCast. And now, Bhaskar, so how do you feel?
Hello. First of all, hello to everyone. It's always a great pleasure to be associated with you guys. Yeah, you were asking me something.
Yeah, so how did you feel about the match? How's the adrenaline flowing still?
Oh, yeah. The thing is, since last 2 days, I'm having prawn curry in all my meals. Whether it's prawn cutlet and prawn pakoras and the prawn Goan curry. And you can feel the importance of Goa now. Yeah, obviously, I am 1,900 kilometers away from Kolkata. But those who don't stay in Kolkata, it's very difficult to express the fever of derby. That volcanic expulsion of emotions and aggression among the supporters of both Mohunbagan and East Bengal. All those cute abuses, all those slogans, Jotobar Darbi, Totobar Harbi, all those cute slogans, those were missing. But one thing I feel about this ISL is now, this Kolkata Derby, this emotion and fever was only concentrated in Kolkata and Bengal. But due to ISL, now I can see this excitement overall, like pan-India. This excitement has spread, and I was following the match in social media platforms when millions and millions of people were supporting. Most of the supporters were for ATK Mohunbagan. And
just to interrupt you, I would like to inform you that I had been out on the streets while the derby was going on, and I can tell you the old atmosphere felt pretty much back, because there were LCD screens in the locality, and there were flags all over. So the feeling, during this time, wasn't
great,
there.
Great, even during this due to pandemic, but I can feel that heat from Mumbai, and that typical adrenaline gush. Yes.
Yeah, and so what is your takeaway from this match? So have you enjoyed Mohunbagan's performance, or as a fan, do you feel there is a lot of?
Of course, I have enjoyed a lot. Because Mohunbagan happened to be a very balanced team, especially our defense was very strong this time. It was like an unbreachable citadel this time. And I will also say that if you look at the stats, that the ball position with East Bengal was very good. Okay, and even East Bengal played well. And since East Bengal has to digest 2 goals, nobody is talking about Debjit Mojumdar. But I must say that in 36th minute, there was a chance of Mohunbagan. Hernandez has taken a very good shot towards the goal, but Debjit Mojumdar saved it well. So it was always in derby, it happened to be a 50-50 chance. But Roy Krishna was in his full form. So even he proved himself in the Kerala match too. So if you follow that from 55th, I think from 55th or 56th minute up to 70 minutes, the momentum was with East Bengal. But what I felt is, I think you all must be remembering that slogan of that Uri, that famous dialogue, the Uri surgical strike. How is the Josh? Hi, sir. That body language somewhere was missing in East Bengal. Because I think it's a derby match which was out from, it was away from the hometown. Things would have been a much different if it was the Juba Bharati or any like Ravindra Sarovar Stadium of Kolkata. But I think Mohunbagan was a better team than East Bengal this time, and in ISL also. So the better team deserved, and always I think the showstopper was Manvir. And if East Bengal would have scored goal in the last moment, I think in extra time the things would have been more different. But I think always the
this is a league match, so
yeah. But so I think
any message to East Bengal fans?
Any message, East Bengal fans? I should say that they have celebrated their centenary this year. I think they should. The days are not far. They should be celebrating the centenary of their I League win. So,
and that's pretty harsh. That was harsh.
But I can assure you, this is the best banter I've heard.
Yeah, but and I should also say that jotobar derby totobar harbi, and see, this ISL is for ATK Mohun Bagan. I think the way they have performed in the two matches, yeah, I have seen, and Roy Krishna and Manvir is in full form, so I think there is no iota of doubt about this, that this ISL will be coming to our club once again.
Yeah, but one thing I'd definitely like to point out, there is no East Bengal without Mohun Bagan and the other way around.
Absolutely.
We need each other to survive.
Of course, and we need each other. I should say this, that being a diehard Mohun Bagan fan also, I also have respect. See, ultimately in that derby match, football has won. Our emotions has won once again. Winning and losing is a part of just a competition. And see, without East Bengal and Mohun Bagan, this relation is like husband and wife. Without each one, the other can't survive. So this aggression, this fight, this will continue, and I think because of this, Indian football is surviving. I think.
Absolutely. So I think on this.
It's understandable. Bhaskar is, once a moment. Bhaskar is going towards marriage, and that's understandable the way he speaks right now.
Because he's now good in balancing. So anyways.
I am being trained and tamed.
All the best for that, and congratulations.
Yeah,
so signing off from FCast.
And one more to my message to all the FCast fans, that please follow our page, and there is a lot of productive discussion going on. And all the best to you guys, the way you are working hard on the stats and match analysis. I think that it's great going, and I am always a big fan, and I always feel the pleasure to be associated with you guys.
Thank you. Pleasure is all ours. We can tell it, and it's not an association. You have always been a part of us. It's not like an association kind of thing, because you had been very closely associated with us and closely been a part of it since its incorporation.
My pleasure.
So once again, a lot of thanks to you for that. From the entire team.
Pleasure is all mine. Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you so much.